Oh, I'm just a woman. Help me believe what I could be and all that I am. Oh, show me still. Teach me to take one day at a time. One day at a time.
Yeah. for he led us to find new strength. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, grace and mercy be with you, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. You have faith in God, have faith also in me. In my Father's house, there are many dwelling places. If there were not, would I have told you that I'm going to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come back again to take you to myself, so that where I am, you also may be. Where I am going, you know the way." Thomas said to him, "Master, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated. My brothers and sisters in Christ, life is a fragile thing. We never know for sure just how much time we have. We think we know, but we don't. Recent advances in medicine have pushed back the inevitable march of death. But each one of us has a day when we shall draw our last breath. The day has come for our sister, Elaine Brathwaite. We are gathered here today in this church to pay tribute to her. For all of us, this is a time of sorrow, but it is a time of sorrow mixed with joy. It is a time of sorrow because we realize that for a time we will not be able to see her. Sorrow because of the touch that will not be felt. Sorrow because of a smile that will not be seen. Sorrow because of a laugh that will not be heard. Sorrow because of a voice that no longer beckons us near. Sorrow because of a love that will be remembered but not experienced firsthand. Yes, there is sorrow in this time of death. But there is also great joy. There is great joy because today, the woman we honor today, Elaine, is a Christian. Joy because she has turned her life to Jesus. Joy because she has been bathed in the blood of the Lamb. Joy because she made a decision to embrace the cross of Jesus Christ. Joy because she believed in the death and the resurrection of Jesus. She believed that all those who are united to Jesus Christ will share in his life and resurrection forever. Many of us find departures difficult, especially when the person departing from us is significant for us in some way. The words Jesus speaks in today's gospel reading are set by the evangelist John within the context of the Last Supper on the evening before Jesus was crucified. Jesus is about to leave his disciples. Yet, in leaving them, he also assures them that he is not abandoning them. He will, in fact, come back to them. That's the promise Jesus made to his disciples. I shall return to take you with me. That promise is generally heard as a promise that at the end of our earthly lives, Jesus will come and take us to the many warmed house of his Father, which is why the reading is so chosen for the funeral liturgy. However, Jesus goes on to assure his disciples that we don't have to wait to the end of our lives to experience his coming. He will come to us in and through the Paraclete, the Holy Spirit. Through the Holy Spirit, Jesus Christ comes to us here and now. He comes to us today, and he's coming through the Holy Spirit. He's a foretaste in anticipation of his coming to us at the end of our lives. That's why St. Paul refers to the Spirit as the first fruit of the final harvest, which is eternal life. For Elaine, God the Father has called her home, and God was waiting for her with open arms. Can you imagine the joy of finally being in the presence of God, the presence of the one who created the universe, the presence of one who created us, the joy of hearing the voice of God, the one who commanded the light to be separated from the darkness, saying, "Welcome home." The joy of expressing the presence, the joy of experiencing the presence of God in heaven, where there is no more tear, no more pain, no more suffering. There, we all are destined to this place, to be with God forever. That's the reason why God has created us, to experience momentarily his presence on earth, and one day to share eternally his presence forever, his presence in heaven. The saints are there too in heaven. All of the Christians who left this earth before Elaine are there. Christian friends whom she has wept over because she no longer have their fellowship, they will be there. That fellowship will be renewed in Jesus Christ. In heaven, we will experience all God had in store for us: life forever, love forever, in the presence of God, in the presence of the saints, in the presence of the beloved ones we have known on earth, and we are going to live with in heaven. My brothers and sisters in Christ, Christians who live on this earth do not really belong here. We are here for a temporary purpose. We are here to glorify God. But our first home is in heaven. The good news is that God invited all of us to reach there, to meet that goal. That's why He sent us the Holy Spirit. He sent us Jesus Christ first. He sent us His Holy Spirit. And Jesus Christ lives for us, this community of believers, the church, through which we nourish our lives, through His Word, through His sacraments, to experience here on earth His presence, His goodness, and prepare ourselves to share His life for eternity. May God accompany us during this moment of difficulty, so that with His grace we can hold firm to Him, so that with Him we can continue our journey with God and prepare us to share with Him and all our beloved who believe in Jesus Christ to share eternity. Amen. Please stand. God, the Almighty Father, raised Christ, His Son, from the dead. With confidence, we ask Him to save all His people.
Please respond, Lord, hear our prayer. For Elaine, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that she may now be admitted to the company of the saints, we pray to the Lord. For our sister, who ate the body of Christ, the bread of life, that she may be raised up on the last day, we pray to the Lord. For our deceased relatives and friends, and for all who have helped us, that they may have the reward of their goodness, we pray to the Lord. For those who have fallen asleep in the hope of rising again, that they may see God face to face, we pray to the Lord. For the family and friends of our sister Elaine, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord who wept at the death of His friend Lazarus, we pray to the Lord. For all of us assembled here to worship in faith, that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom, we pray to the Lord.
God, our shelter and our strength, You listen in love to the cry of Your people. Hear the prayers offered for Elaine. Cleanse her from her sins and grant her the fullness of redemption through Christ our Lord. Amen.
Thank you.
foundation of the world, the life of the human race, the resurrection of the dead, proven possible, the post of angels, and also marriage, rejoicing in your presence as well. Hear our voices, pray for your desires, the monitors of God's way as the day.
Thank you.
May we always pray for the sin and save for all these quests, as we wait for death and hope the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to our apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and grace, in accordance with your will, living with forever and ever.
Amen.
Peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Today is a very solemn day for our family. We have lost someone who has made so many inroads, so many pathways for us being here. My aunt, Tanti Elaine,
saying, places, and everyone shared the hand of the contributions. In this way, she was compelled to say, and she did, she will go on here trips. All you have to say to her, we are going somewhere, and she will say, sign me up. And she will say, for that trip. And because of these examples of enjoying life, I try to understand. China, travel all over the world. Here in Germany, Japan, Tahiti, Paris, Rome, Hawaii, Israel, and Ghana, and many more. All places she has been to, she always had a new camera, but couldn't operate it. Despite the fact that uncle was sure how to use it, she would write postcards and say, I was here. Auntie loved life. For many of us who have experience of going shopping with her, we had to try and keep up with her because she was such an energetic person. She loved family and she will take us shopping and we will have to run after her just to keep up, either through the train or the bus. And we were young. She was strong. She had to help. She had a strong mind. County healing, as far as I know, was loved by just about everyone. She loved social gatherings. She loved hosting parties at her residence and things in her. And I wrote many stories about those parties, and later on at her house on East 49th Street, where she hosted barbecues and great parties. Whatever it was, it could have been the 4th of July, the Thanksgiving, or the parties, nothing was too much for her. And she will do anything for you, give or off of her, because she thought you needed more than her. And despite the fact that my aunt was so loving and caring, don't you ever cross her path. She will let you have it. As good as she is and as spiritual as she was, if you cross the path, not family members, but other people, you would think that this is not the show. Amazing thing when you ask Sandy, how you doing? Her response always, I'm holding on to that line. Indeed she did. She did it for 93 years until she could not hold on anymore. She fought for the life. My dear aunt, we will miss you. We will miss you dear. I know you have to go on up to Uncle as you used to call him. Say hello for us. May God bless you.
Christ. As we go our separate ways, let us take leave of our sister Elaine. May our farewell express our affection for her. May it ease our sadness and strengthen our hope. One day we shall joyfully greet her again. When the love of Christ is compared to compares all things, destroys even death itself.
Thank you. Is grace that